All right. Hello, everybody, and welcome back.
Hello there.
Hello there, ugly monkey. How we doing?
Let's switch on over here. Come on, folks.
Let's have
Allow
a drink.
Me to formally express my sincerest gratitude.
Oh, thank you, Mango. Mango,
hello. Just cheers.
We're back.
Bits.
We're
this
here again.
1 p.m. MST, you early.
1 p.m. MST, you early. Time zone change. Time zone, daylight savings time, thingamadoober. It's been 84 years! I know, right? It's been so long since we've done anything Genshin, and I'm so glad I'm able to at least do this. Like, I am over the moon excited. Oh my gosh, I cannot wait. The live stream says it's only 30 minutes long, but knowing me and how I chatter, we'll see how long it takes. But I'm excited. I can't wait. I'm extremely excited for Ororon. We're finally getting news about him. Oh, let me grab that water. Hang on. I got water with a little bit of G Fuel in it. My head's not hurting today, so yay! I took some medicine, so my back isn't hurting either, which is really good. So we're feeling great today. With that said, after this, I am going to record Archon Quest Part 4. I haven't done it yet, so I'm probably going to get spoilers in this live stream for it. But that's okay. Oh! You want a bat? Ororon purple. I'm trying to think what color purple that would be. I'm going to have to like grab an image of him. Or something. Or guess. Ororon purple. It's like a... almost like that. Hang on, let me show it so you guys can see what I see. Boom. Here, we'll have him behind the couch. We'll have him peeking. Medley's like, me hearing no here knowing all the secrets. I know, right? I'm so late to this, but that's all right. Oh, but I can't wait. I'm so excited. I can't wait. There isn't really a spoiler in it from what I know. Okay, good. Good, good, good. Because after stream, I was planning on recording that part 4, so I'm all caught up and I can talk about things with people, finally. So the sooner we get this wrapped up, the sooner I can get that recorded. But I'm excited. Alrighty. So how this works, as a reminder, what we'll be doing, I won't be reading chat until we get to those break sections. Once we get to those break sections, then you and me, we can like talk about what we just saw and like went over what just happened and things like that, and then we'll go back to it. I think there are about 3 breaks. Now wait a minute, what did I do? What did I mess up on? I think there are 3... What? there are 3 breaks throughout the live stream. So we'll have 3 opportunities to talk about it. And then at the very end, we'll go over everything. So I recommend that you guys don't do any spoilers. If you don't know if we've seen something, wait until one of those breaks or wait until the very end and we'll all talk about it together. Alrighty?
Sutter, hello! Love your face, can't stay but want to say hi. Hi!
Let's have a drink!
Thank you for the hydrate. Good old classic hydrate and run. Revenge is sweet, isn't it? Oh, I'll grab that hydrate. Thank you, thank you. All right, so let's go ahead and pause this and head on over. Chat, one thing though, do let me know if it's too quiet or too loud. Please let me know. I want to make sure you guys can hear it. So let me pause that, pop on over here. Alrighty, and let's get going.
We're a tribe of warriors. In ancient times, we were responsible for patrolling and defending all of Natland.
Oh, we get the bird! Oh, we get the bird!
So Ulchcon's still managing to sow discord, even after all these years.
There
if
she is!
Resolve the conflict through dialogue. Sometimes you need a third-party facilitator.
And there's that,
the easiest person
weird gun.
Ah! What was that? Oh! What was that? It was so cute!
His spirit has gotten lost and can't find its way back to his body.
That's my boy!
And Granny won't let me.
Oh, he's so cool. I'm sorry.
What is that? Oh, it's so cute! you little bat!
Mystery surfaced again.
Yes, Capitano!
I worry that we risk repeating the mistakes of the Cinder City.
That place is cool! The whole,
as long as the soul is involved, I should be able to help.
Oh, that's cool. I want to fight it. I don't care what it is. I want to fight it.
Ooh! It changes forms?
Take me up!
It changes forms to the old bosses! What? Oh, I want
to
fight it.
Knock him down.
Okay, I have to admit, her Night Soul blessing markings are so cool.
It's either your end or mine.
Oh, what was that? It was like a purple dragon. Yeah, that! What's that? Was that a bat? Oh, look at that! Look at that! Look at my boy! Oh my gosh. I'm sorry. I'm gonna be freaking out a lot. I'm sorry. Why is he cool? Why is also Solali look so sad? What? Okay, that's a lot to unpack. Oh my gosh, that's a lot to unpack. Okay, hold on. I can get that blue. Hang on, I can so
Let's
get that
have a
blue.
Drink.
Yeah, I'm gonna need to hydrate after that. Did you see him? Did you see the little baby bat too? It was so cute. Here, we're gonna put it on the other side. No, hang on, we're gonna make them share. Bat, scoot over.
Scoot.
What was that? Can I actually select color, pick screen color? Can I? Yeah, I can. There it is.
Hey,
wait!
Travelers.
Wait. I'm not ready. Wait. I gotta move the bats. I'm not ready. I'm not ready for you to move on yet. I'm not there. Wait. Got it. Yeah, it's the Quaposaurus, the bird thing that we saw in that one weird world quest. It's really cool that we actually get to see like more of them and stuff. Like, that's neat. Here we go. Look above the six, right above. No, back to the 5 seconds. Look above the six. No, the red. Wait, what? Hang on. Above the six is blue. Hang on. Back here? Which six? Where? What? Huh? Help! Help! What? Chat is slow. Please hold while chat is loading. Mothmanthus wine tastes the same as I remember. But where are those who share the memory? Little guy above six.
Oh, he's so cute! Oh, he's adorable! Look at him! He's got the big old ears and things like that. He's just like, hello! Hello! Oh, he's cute! Oh, he's cutie patootie.
Oh, thank you for grabbing those. Let me pin that there for everyone. There you go. I am so excited to learn more about these guys. All right, let's keep going. Because there wasn't really too much to talk about. We need to unpack it. We need to know what's going on. We gotta know. Also, I am so saving this image as like my background on my phone for a while. That is sick. That is so cool. Big fan.
Hey, travelers.
There we go.
Welcome to the Genshin Impact version 5.2 special program. I'm Gabe from the Loke team.
Hi, Gabe.
And I'm Kai. We meet again.
Hi, Kai.
Whoa, a cuckoosaur. Want to join
cuckoosaur,
us?
Cuckoosaur. That's
hey,
how they say
don't
it.
Don't be shy. Come out and say hello.
It's so cute.
Look at those little wings.
I'm not sure what that meant, but it was adorable.
It's so sassy.
She approves of your compliment.
Hey, I didn't know you could speak Saurian.
Oh, I can't. But I can make an educated guess based on her body language.
This is cute.
Whoa, are all cuckoosaurs as friendly as this one?
Adult cuckoosaurs are usually very proud creatures, but there are always exceptions.
That's true.
Well, since our cuckoosaur friend kicked things off for us, I know just the place to start. The Flower Feather Clan.
Ooh,
all right, let's do it.
We got a good look at that.
Cuckoosaurs live among the Flower Feather Clan, which is suspended high above the mountains. This is a tribe of warriors, and most of their people can command the power of the skies. It was the Flowerfeather Clan's ancient duty to patrol and safeguard the entire region of Natlan. As elite special forces, their job was to detect threats, disseminate intel, and quickly neutralize any dangers to the nation.
Are a lot of them archers? I'm seeing a lot of like archery targets.
The tribe never forgot its origins. They still hold trials to assemble the fastest teams in the tribe.
Oh, we have gliding.
Pilot skill and teamwork with the Cuckoosaurs.
Oh,
adult Cuckoosaurs
so
look so cool. Look at that on the left.
Cuckoosaurs.
Yeah, Cuckoosaurs are the proudest out of all the Saurians. They know that they're the kings of the sky. Cuckoosaurs can consume phlogiston to climb higher or perform a horizontal roll in midair. Holding the sprint button allows them to enter an accelerated glide state after a horizontal roll. In addition, they can even use phlogiston wind tunnels to quickly cover.
Oh my gosh, we can fly.
Okay,
so we can fly in Genshin.
Cuckoosaurs are really hard to tame.
Yeah,
that's cool.
That's
gonna be cool.
You need to prove yourself in Expression's some worthwhile so easy feat, too. Like demonstrating exceptional archery skill during flight. That's the only way to become a true Cuckoosaur rider.
Oh, I might like these people.
They're so strict.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, tell me about it. But okay, now that we've got a glimpse of the Flowerfeather Clan, it's time for a quiz.
What? Oh, I wasn't taking
Already?
Notes.
Yep, I hope you're prepared. Every tribe in Natlan has a unique way of communicating with their Saurian companions.
Uh-oh.
The members of the Flowerfeather Clan use a special item to summon their Cuckoosaurs. What is that item?
A basket filled with their favorite foods?
I don't know,
a
whistle?
We just saw the answer in the previous video.
Oh, I remember now. Horn.
Ding, ding, ding.
Oh.
Cuckoosaurs live far from the tribe and from each other. So in order to summon them, the tribe's people use whistles and horns to produce loud noises.
Hey, I was kind of right.
So there's your overview of Cuckoosaurs. Maybe they sound a little unapproachable compared to other Saurians, but don't worry, travelers. If you get into a tough situation, then Chaska, the Flowerfeather Clan's
Here
expert peacemaker, can help mediate the conflict.
Knitch mentioned that her method of mediation is silencing both parties. Is that true?
Well, that's only in special cases. Most of the time, Chaska barely needs to intervene. Everyone knows what she's capable of, so people usually find a way to set aside their differences when she shows up.
Oh, so she doesn't just handle conflicts between humans and Saurians. She keeps the peace between people, too.
Exactly.
Makes
Chaska
sense.
Was corrupted by abyssal power as a child, so she has a strong compulsion to fight, but she knows how to rein it in.
Right. I heard that she was abandoned as a baby. Mm. It seems like she's been through a lot.
Yeah, but luckily for her, the Cuckoosaurs took her in and raised her as one of their own. In addition to hunting and flying, Chaska gained a lot of unique combat experience from her Saurian childhood. When Chaska is in your party, defeating monsters will restore phlogiston to your party.
Ooh,
while she's in the
Night Soul's
blessing state, Chaska can ride and control her gun like a Cuckoosaur. The Soul Sniper doesn't just increase her movement speed and resistance to interruption. It also allows her to get a better angle on her enemies.
Wow.
I'm still on the fence about that gun. It
so
doesn't
cool.
feel
it
right.
Seems so liberating.
Yeah. And
love that bow.
When she's in the zone.
Look at that
in the
bow.
Night Soul's blessing state, Chaska's normal attacks deal animo damage to enemies in front of her. Unleashing a charged attack in this state will cause Chaska to enter a special aiming mode. This allows
her
to lock onto
cool.
a set number of enemies within range and fire up to 6 Shadow Hunt shells, which deal animo damage upon impact. In addition, for every
I think
pyro,
I'll get used to it over
hydro,
time. It's just
cryo,
so
or electro
it
character
just
in
throws
your party,
me off.
One of Chaska's Shadow Hunt shells will undergo an elemental
conversion. Feels like it should be a Fontaine thing, not a
type of
Natlan
damage.
Thing.
Whoa, no way! So Chaska can directly deal other types of elemental damage based on the characters in her party.
Mm-hmm.
And since she's an animal character, she can swirl them at the same time. That's awesome.
Yeah, I know, right?
Look how her high up she can go. Like, what's the limit on
too.
The
Chaska
up?
Chaska fires a gale-splitting Soul Seeker shell during her burst, which deals animo damage. The attack
Again,
then
that Night Soul blessing.
Soul
like, the marking
shells,
is so cool on her, because even her outfit
enemies.
Lights up.
These
like, the edges of her scarf and her hair.
Conversion.
It's so pretty,
so
but that's
cool.
going to take a long
no
time to get used
one
to.
One of the strongest warriors in her tribe.
Speaking of her tribe,
wait,
the warriors from the Flower Feather clan are formidable for sure, but we should also shed some
hold on, I need to think. Isn't that Clorend's animation? Isn't that Clorend's idol? Did they just reuse an idol? Oh, I got questions.
On those who aren't as skilled.
Oh, are you talking about the wingless? That's what the tribe calls people who fail the flight trials.
Oh, they
right?
call them wingless?
The challengers who fail to earn the recognition
that hurts.
Of the Kukasaur.
Exactly. But the name doesn't indicate that those people are weak or deserve to be cast aside. The Flowerfeather clan has its own definition of strength. There's a tacit understanding that the wingless are supposed to be protected until they can fly by themselves.
Ah.
But that assumption is challenged in Tribal Chronicles Tlalocan. Someone will dare to ask, what if you didn't need a Kukasaur to fly? If you could change the rules, then maybe there wouldn't be any wingless to begin with. Now, whether
that's going
right
to be an interesting story quest
for us to discover.
Gosh, we have so many story quests we need to go through now. We're so behind.
So, be sure to check out Chaska's Tribal Chronicle if you're interested in what happens.
Oh, it's a Tribal Chronicle. Oh, never mind. I'm going to be doing that sooner than I thought.
Remember how I mentioned that Chaska was raised by Kukasaurs?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, tell us about it.
Her Saurian mother will make an appearance in this quest.
Oh.
Even though she's joined human society, Chaska still goes to visit her Saurian mother on occasion, especially when she needs some help with a tough situation.
Oh, so Chaska still has the soft side, even though she's a fearsome warrior.
Definitely.
Get to go see Bird Mom.
The Flower Feather Clan is also the setting for the Archon Quest Chapter 5 interlude. All fires fuel the flame.
Is it the interlude already? Really?
Crisis, and they'll need the traveler's help to find a solution.
What kind of crisis?
Oh, yeah, like one more section.
The Flower Feather Clan
and then
suffered
interlude.
The worst of the abyssal contamination during the battle in version 5.1. It's not just the human body that can't withstand high concentrations of abyssal power. For most people, it also damages the mind.
Ooh.
Many members of the Flowerfeather clan are suffering from the mental repercussions of the abyss, and the
tribe is in
desperate need of aid.
I'm sorry, that's a cool Eonton hat.
Eonton will be there too. After rebuilding her own tribe, the Collective of Plenty,
Oron's
she's traveling
friend.
Around Natland to help those in need.
The
Not
people
him.
Of Natland really value unity, don't they? No one fights alone. Right. That's one of my favorite things about Natland. Oh, wait.
Hey,
it looks like the captain will also be there.
Yes, the captain will also offer help to the tribe.
Such a good
you
bean.
You may pick up on some interesting
I want to give Capitano headpats.
Pay close attention to what he has to say. The captain rarely gives away too much information in his regular interactions, but his secrecy here seems a little peculiar. So keep an eye out. But of course, restoring Natland's fighting spirit remains the top priority. After all, the war isn't over yet.
The friend?
The abyssal contamination is still around. And we have a very important
brain do a little burr.
Natland needs mental fortitude more than ever
before. Oh, I got
mixed
up.
The Flower Feather Clan is pretty close to the masters of the Night Wolf.
Here we go.
Where the Tomasaurs live. That tribe.
How do you say that name again? Hold on, we're going back a little bit. I want to hear how they say that name. Hold
Let's
on.
Check it.
Hold on. Go back. How do you say the name of these things? Because I'm going to be saying that a lot.
Is pretty close to the masters of the Night Wind, where the Tomasaurs live. That tribe could be another good place to recover from the battle.
Oh, yeah. Let's check it out.
I missed it again. They'll say it again.
If you head west from the Stadium of the Sacred Flame and go past the towering walls, you eventually arrive at the settlement of the mysterious masters of the Nightwind. The tribal settlement offers a unique landscape at night. If you venture even further, then you might encounter the tribe's Wath Ictomasaur Elder, or one of the many shamans who can communicate with spirits. I even heard
that the
witch doctors who live there can help cleanse your spirit. Plus, the graffiti art is really incredible.
Oh, that's
In fact,
beautiful.
There's something special about this one. Can you figure it out, travelers?
It's like a bat.
It's
like
kind of tricky,
sideways.
Right? Well, don't worry. The Ictomasaurs can help us out. Ictomasaurs are known for their wisdom. They can use their unique sight to detect things that can't be seen through normal means.
Oh,
okay.
That's cool.
Ectomysaurs are especially skilled at detecting ley lines and phlogiston. They can absorb power from phlogiston objects to enhance their abilities. Doing so allows them to jump higher, move faster, or even obtain surprising rewards.
Oh, I'm
going to
be traveling around Natlin like this thing.
Ectomysaurs can also extract information from graffiti art to create special objects.
What?
I bet that'll come in handy for solving puzzles.
Ectomysaur, thank you.
Especially in Tribal Chronicles Mictlan, which will become available in version 5.2, the first two acts feature a lot of intriguing puzzles.
Oh,
so be sure
I
to check them out,
them.
Travelers. Some of them will require the help of an Ectomysaur.
I want a plush of them like now.
I noticed that Ectomysaurs can perform fast-paced jumps when they have enough phlogiston, and it looks like so much fun.
Oh,
do
look
we
at
know
them.
Anyone who can use that ability? Besides the new Saurian, I mean.
Yes, Auroron yes! can do it too. Like the Ectomysaurs, Auroron has the ability to rise into the air.
Yeah, we can't
he
shoot them there, let's go!
He also has a keen sense of perception. While charging an aimed shot, Auroron will enter the Spirit Speaker state, allowing him to extract power from Natlan's graffiti and runes.
Speaking
of
Auroron,
he has the full ability of the
surprised by his personality. Ectomysaur. Before the 5.1 Archon quest, I thought that
cool.
he looked like a
I knew
stern,
he had the jump, but I didn't know he had the vision, like
harsh
the sight.
Type of character. But as it turns out, he's just a sweet kid.
Yeah.
He's adorable.
Kind of unexpected, right? Is he really that sweet, though? Just to think about all the sneaking around behind his granny's back.
True.
The tribespeople of the Masters of the Nightwind are known for being eccentric. But Auroron really takes it to the next level.
Yeah, it sounds like he does things his own way. I wonder if that extends to his combat abilities.
It does. Auroron is a bit different from the Natlan characters we've met so far. He doesn't need to depend on the Night Soul's Blessing State to gain Night Soul points, and he can maintain the Night Soul's Blessing State even while he's off-field.
I'm sorry, I'm not even listening to what they're saying. That was too cute!
From the other Natlan characters. So how do his abilities work?
Okay, focus, focus.
Let me start by explaining how Auroron gains Night Soul points.
Uh-huh.
This can happen in multiple ways. For example, Auroron can gain Night Soul points when one of his party members triggers a Night Soul Burst. He can also gain them when other party members deal Hydro or Electro attacks to enemies after Auroron unleashes his Elemental skill.
Oh, then it sounds like he works well with Hydro and Electro characters.
Yep.
Which is perfect.
In combat,
someone
when
put enemies
take damage from electro-charged reactions or other party members deal Night Soul aligned damage, Auroron can consume Night Soul points to enter the Night Soul's Blessing state and trigger the Hypersense effect, dealing electro damage.
Oh, I see. So you need to pair him with the right characters if you want him to gain Night Soul points, enter the Night Soul's Blessing state,
that, like,
and trigger the effect.
Of his cape,
exactly.
That's so cool.
Though I should mention that Auroron doesn't need to be
ooh,
on the field
hang on, Ayato
to trigger
team
the Hypersense effect.
Wait, he can trigger it even while he's off-field? That sounds really useful.
Totally. His Elemental Burst provides a convenient way to deal damage and support your party.
Huh.
Auroron performs an ancient ritual with his burst to summon a supersonic Oculus.
That's so cool that he can just jump up and stay out of the way. That is so cool.
The Oculus releases a sound wave to deal damage.
That should be great for crowd control.
Yes, I am so glad I pre-built two different ways
with
for
large
him.
Groups of enemies should be a
that's
lot
actually
easier.
A really big AoE
and
now looking at
making
it.
Making things easier, Auroron can also improve the exploration experience by boosting the gliding speed of your
yes!
characters.
Awesome.
Oh,
Auroron
thank
really
you.
Auroron cherishes his friends. With a little teamwork on his side, I'm sure victory will always
oh,
be
oh, I don't have to use that stupid fan no more.
Cool. So we introduced two of the upcoming
holy cow, there's a lot to talk
update.
About. When's break?
The Flutterfeather Clan and the Masters of the Nightwind.
Oh my gosh,
but
when's
there's
break?
There's more. Version 5.2 actually introduces another new region. It's called Ochkanatlan.
Oh,
I'm going
I
to have
think
a
we
trouble pronouncing that thing.
Ancient city when we're looking at the Flutterfeather Clan. It's really beautiful from far away,
it is
but those
really
clouds
pretty.
Look kind of ominous.
Fog and the
it looks completely abandoned.
Almost like
is it dangerous?
Yes.
Not
this
moss,
is a restricted
like
area in that land
plants.
Due to its severe abyssal contamination, and it seems
abyssal
uninhabited. Over the years, many adventurers have come
ooh,
here
what's
in
that
search
little
of
thing floating
treasure
by us?
Or
that's
to
cute.
Slay the dragon. Unfortunately, none of them have ever returned. The Flutterfeather Clan often sends riders to patrol the area and to prevent people from getting too close.
That's
wait,
good.
Did you say slay the dragon?
Yeah, I know we introduced some adorable Saurians earlier, but this creature is actually really terrifying. It occupies this ancient city and guards it fiercely. If it detects an intruder, then it will attack without hesitation.
That's
giving me, like,
concerned.
First time seeing Dvalin vibes.
It's easy to take human-Saurian coexistence for granted these days, but it actually took generations of effort to reach this point. This relationship wasn't nearly so harmonious in the ancient past.
I love how the Traveler jumped over that fire. That's funny.
Travelers will need to explore land to uncover the reason behind this dragon's rampage. Of course, travelers won't have to do this alone. Here, take a look.
Oh,
yeah,
what's that?
Who's the little
this
buddy?
This is a very important companion who will help us explore Ojkanetland. His name is Kokoeek.
Kokoeek.
As for his power, well, why don't you take a guess?
Okay, is he our moral support?
Oh, absolutely, he's moral support. 10 out of 10, he's moral support.
Cheer us up.
Hey, let's not put our Tepetlasaur friend out of a job. Little one works really hard.
Okay, then I've got nothing.
Remember how I mentioned that Ojkanetland is heavily corroded by the Abyss? Well, that's where Kokoeek comes in. We can use his power to clear abyssal contamination. Follow the direction indicated by his light to collect secret source scraps and enhance his power. Once Kokoeek has enough power, you can take him to track down the evil dragon.
What a useful little guy.
Interesting.
I know, right? Now, travelers can explore Ojkanetland with two
light and dark kind of
Kokoeek and Little One. In fact, I've heard there's even a special token around here that can enable Little One to traverse a volcano.
Hmm.
A new adventure with Little One awaits in version 5.2.
We have like the second part of that
this
token we need to find by the volcano.
One step closer to uncovering the mysteries of Little One's past. Familiar Saurian companions can also help us explore Ojkanetland. For example, with the help of a Koholosaur, we can evade source mechanism attacks.
Oh, that's going to be tricky.
With the help of an Ikidomisaur, we can solve certain puzzles. With the help of a Kukusaur, we might even be able to chase down the evil dragon. But we'll leave the rest for you to discover, travelers.
Wait, are those some kind of lava fish?
Ah!
Does this mean we can fish in that land?
Yes, but
I've
got
yes!
some friendly advice, travelers.
Let me fish.
You should be very
Let
careful while exploring Ojkanetland. Some of the abyssal monsters
tell me about
can
that thing.
Distort
Ooh,
their
is that the wait? Is that the same thing?
Powerful enemies. High-level monsters such as the Tenebrous Papilla can mimic even
Tenebrous
stronger enemies.
Papilla. Uh-huh.
It looks like these monsters take the form of plants outside of combat.
Yeah,
that's
cool.
True. The abyss has corroded Netland's ley lines, allowing these monsters to read the memories inside of them and mimic creatures from Teyvat.
How do we defeat them?
Travelers will need to use elemental attacks to break
wait,
the enemy's
be...
protective
it's...
void
Hang
wards.
On.
Doing so allows them to take damage and causes them to enter a brief state of confusion. Night Soul aligned elemental attacks are especially effective against these wards.
Wow.
Okay, so Natlin or Swirl.
So advanced. It's scary to think about how much harder these fights will
I
get.
I wonder how big the roster of characters they can morph into is.
Yeah.
Like, is it going to be like
a,
the same three? Is it going to like
once.
Rotate between
but
like 27?
We take our first break, we still have a couple of short announcements. Really short, I promise.
First I need
up,
a break, please.
Inspiration rewards will be available.
I
want to
talk about all this.
2. Just like in version 5.1, travelers can earn up to 400 extra primos.
Yay, extra primos! I'm gonna need them.
Will be available all the way through version 5.3. It's now time to introduce the event wishes.
Oh, I'm scared.
In the first half of version 5.2,
Not
travelers can look forward to event wishes from Chaska and Lenny.
Lenny?
Auroron will also receive a drop rate boost.
Oh, he's part of Chaska. That makes me nervous.
Of version 5.2, we'll have returning event wishes
wait,
for Zhongli
wait,
and
okay.
Rubilette.
Forget this. I don't know where the break is. We're gotten really far. I'm taking that break here. I'm sorry. Did they really just pair the two old dragons with each other? I'm sorry, this is gonna be the most awkward banner ever.
I will have order.
Why? Why did they put the two dragons together? Why? Oh my gosh, I can't. I can't. I can't. Gotta drain the primos before Muleika, I guess. Yeah, I don't know. All right, we're taking that break here. Say that again. Got to drain the primos before Muleika, the Pyro Archon. Oh gosh. Okay, yeah, we have a lot to go through. Good Lord. Okay, question. Didn't Lenny have a rerun already? Hold the phone. Didn't he have a rerun? Like, I swear he was like the first banner in Fontaine. Why is he back? I mean, if I didn't already have two copies of his bow, then I would probably try to get whatever Chaska's bow would be. But oh no. Oh no, this is going to be like a second rerun, third banner. The boss for Mulani is a Kokosaur with the mark of the Flame Lord's blessing. Like a little guy if you look closely. Oh, that's kind of cute. Saving for Mulika. It took so long to get Hu Tao, so now you're saving. Ooh, there you go, there you go. Oh my gosh. Okay, this is a problem. Originally, I was going to pull for Chaska because, like, her personality and the fact that she has, like, she's been in the Abyss. She's really, really cool. That gun is throwing me off. So I think if I had to pick between trying to pull for, like, I think it's going to be, like, a C1 Lenny or Chaska, we might go for Chaska. But I'm going to be aiming for Aurorod. Now, question is, do I keep going until I get a 5-star? Or do I keep going until we get C6 or Auron? Because also the problem is, this is phase 1. If it was phase 2, I'll just wait and see what version 5.3 would be. But I don't have that luxury with this one. Yeah, I gotta make the Abyssal team. Gotta start working on updates. Slideshow, yeah! So right now we're at 50-50, and I have... Actually, I can boot up Genshin on my phone and take a look. I think I have 210 wishes saved. I haven't pulled for a really long time, and I've been like saving like a mad lad. It's been nuts. So it's not a problem about bank. It's whether or not to save. Because besides Auroron, the only other characters I really, really want are Silali and the Pyro Archon Mulika. Otherwise, I am waiting for Harbingers, and I am waiting for Shesnaya, because I'm going to get all the characters in Shesnaya. But this makes me wonder what the heck was going to do. Yes, I did the world quest offline about the volcano. I did do that. It's going to be interesting. Have the Oratrice decide. Yes, the Oratrice mechanique. And it is going to know. Ba-dum-ba-ba-ba-dum. Oh my gosh. This... This is going to be rough. We are really just going to have to play it by ear and see how we do. Hang on, it's booting up. It's stuck on the Geo icon. All right, let me take a look. So I am sitting at 230 wishes with 1,200 primos. And in the Paimon's...
Never pull just for 4 stars is the famous saying for a reason.
I know! But look at him! Hand, please. Look at him! He's so cool! I can't... He's a bat! I need him. Oh my gosh, my favorite animals are whales and bats, and Genshin provided me 2 characters on those animals. I have to. But with like the Paimon bargain, like the star glitter, I have 20 extra pulls there. So that's 27. So I have 257 pulls if I use everything. And that's not including the last part of the Archon quest that I still need to do, and the 400 for completing it, and then all the exploration and event stuff in version 5.2. So we're fine on primos. We're going to be fine on that. It's just... Ugh! It's going to be real tricky trying to figure out. Yeah, we're just going to have to play it by ear and see just how soon Chaska comes home. Because we are on a... Whoops. I need history. 5, 6, 7 pity. We're on 7 pity on 50-50. Man, I thought Kanicha was horribly and I can't read. Can early 5-star when you try for a 4-star, especially if it's a 5-star you don't want. That's what I'm nervous about. Oh, that's right. We do get drip marketing. Oh, Sly, you bring up a good point. Okay, yeah, maybe wait for drip marketing and then decide. Because the main question is, the big overarching question is, do I get just one copy of Ororon and be happy with it and pull for whoever's in the next patch? Or do I go for C6? That's the big question. Because whether or not I get Chaska or not depends on that question alone, is if I get C6 or just one. So we'll see. Cody, hi! Hi,
Chaska
everyone.
Will have more synergy
doing?
With all Ororon. Also,
how
her early
like
cons are more useful.
Why did that double up?
Bravo, comrade. Thanks to your
hey,
help.
Thank you for that follow.
I am one step
Welcome
closer
in, everyone.
To my goal
Hi,
of
my brain
world.
Is broken. My brain is broken. Oh my gosh. But hello, hello. Time to go fanboy.
Bravo, comrade. Thanks to your help, I am one
Wait,
step
it,
closer
it?
To my goal of conquering the world.
What? Oh, it was a double raid. I'm sorry. Satara, hi. That's why it threw me off. I'm like, it should only do one. Why did it do it twice? That's why. Okay, hi. Double raid. I'm still recovering from acute confusional migraines, so my brain cell is not all here. I squirrel a lot. But for those of you who are new, welcome in. My name is Lyra. I'm a sea elf that loves going on adventures here on Twitch. We normally do a lot of Genshin Impact here. We play a lot of different kinds of puzzle games like Danganronpa. Recently, since my head has been hurting, we've been doing some coloring stuff, coloring and like really simple drawings this week. And so today we are looking at the Genshin Impact version 5.2 special program, changing it up a little bit because I absolutely love this game. However, I am breaking. Because I absolutely love Ororon. He's just so, so cool. Problem is, though, he's paired up with Lenny, who I already have, and Chaska, I'm on the fence about. So we were just finished talking about deciding on how on earth I'm going to pull for him. Because I have over 200 wishes saved up, ready to go. I just need to decide what I'm going to do. I just need to figure it out. Welcome in, everybody. If you guys need to go get food or water, or if you need to lurk, please do. I want to make sure you guys are comfy cozy as you hang out with us. Skip and save for the Pyro Archon. We were just thinking that our smartest decision is probably wait for the drip marketing in a week, see what new 5-stars are coming out, and then that will help me decide if I want to have just one copy of Ororon and wait for him to come back again, or if I want to go ahead and just try to get a C6 Ororon. So either way, we're going to be getting him. Whether or not we get Chaska is going to be the question. Archon Act 5 in the next patch, unless they're holding it back for VA reasons, but that would be too fast unless they have lines prepped. That's also very true. Yeah, hey, to Raid and Dash, we got to go get dinner ready. Haven't eaten yet. Go eat food! Go eat food, Satara! Thank you so much for that raid. It's so good seeing you. But he has to hurry up and leave for work, so it may have already been lurk mode. That's perfectly good, too. Oh, there you are. Hi! Gotta ready to run, get ready for work. Yes, absolutely. Thank you guys both so much for the raid. It's so nice seeing you two. Thank you, thank you. Go have fun. Go have fun today. Oh, and hydrate. Good lord. Go drink some water. Actually, everybody in chat, go drink some water. Take a little sip of water. I want to do the same. We all need water today. We all need water. Extra stinky in Lyra's chat. Thanks. There we go. Okay, did I miss anything before the raid? The fantastic people. Chaska will have more synergy with Ororon. Also, her early cons are more useful. That's true, actually. So yeah, I think out of the two, definitely going to go more for Chaska instead of Lenny. Because I use Lenny occasionally, but I tend to use Diluc more and Arlecchino more for Pyro DPS. Granted, my Lenny is fully built, so he's good to go. I think I'm all caught up. I don't think I missed anything. Down rule bear? Hey, that works. Alrighty, let's keep going. I'm gonna die laughing if after this whole event wish thing, they're like, oh, let's have a little break. Because that's been a long time before they had one of those break sections. Alright, here we go.
Wishes from Chaska and Lenny. Auroron will also receive a drop rate boost.
I also can't believe the second patch, they're like the second half, they're doing Zhongli and Nuvolette. That's so funny to me.
I don't advise going for C6, but unless your luck is terrible, you should get at least C0, C3, or Auron plus Chaska with around 100 wishes.
Yeah.
Then you have a bunch of events and a whole banner patch to save.
Yeah, that's true. Because like, I at least want C3 on Auron. So, we'll see. They did say they were about to, possibly. Daddy Banner! That's gotta be so awkward. Just Nuvolette constantly trying to, like, seek out the justice of the Archons, and Zhongli just awkwardly sitting there like, uh-oh. Also, but that bow...
According to the judgment of the Orange Juice Mechanique d'Analyse Cardinal,
we
now turn to the Orange Juice Mechanique d'Analyse Cardinal.
Okay, hang on. Let's get through this, and then I'll keep reading. But this bow is pretty. I want to know its stats.
Four-star weapons. Be sure to check them
out. Oh, it's a four-star weapon.
All right. It's time for our first break.
Hold on. No. Okay, hold on. Wait.
Bravo, comrade. Thanks to your help. I am one step closer to my goal of conquering the world.
Hi, welcome in.
Wait. It looks the same. I know it's two separate bows because of the four-star, but it literally... I gotta have, like, a side-by-side comparison. They look so freaking similar besides the handguard in the front. Like, this section in the front. Otherwise, this whole back half looks the same.
Astral Vultures Crimson Plumage.
Corporate needs you to identify the difference between these two pictures. They're the same.
Two new Netland-specific four-star weapons. Be sure...
Okay.
If you're interested.
All right. It's time for our first break.
Okay.
Once
yeah. Give me that.
Come back,
give me the break.
Right into the event portion.
And then events. Okay. Cool beans. All right. Hi. Wait a minute. They're the same bow. One's just missing feathers. The handguards are the same.
I always got lockies.
Also, hey, Beast. Nice to meet you, too. Hello. Welcome in. Get all comfy cozy as we freak out over pants.
Look at them.
Seriously, the moment they make this thing into a plush, I'm getting it. It's so cute. Like, I'm going to be waddling around as this thing for forever. Oh, they're so adorable. Oh, my heart. I love them. I might, if that's a forced, hang on. Are we okay? Oh, my thing is freaking out. Hang on. Resetting camera. We okay? Hello?
Blah, 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 blah.
Okay, we're good. Okay, there we go. I was like, there is something drastically wrong with my model. There we go. A little bit of a hiccup.
Oh, look at them, they're marching.
But yeah, if that's just gonna be a four star, then
welcome.
I might
back,
just
traveler.
Get the four star bow.
Welcome back. Let's dive straight into the event section. So in the first event, we'll get
the four
to
star
learn
does
more
look better than the five star. I have to admit.
That's yeah. Right. In the version 5.2 event, Ikitomi Spirit Seeking Scrolls.
Ooh, hold on. Look at that sword. Hold. Look at that sword. The event sword? Yeah, that's sick. Oh, I want to know the stats on that. Who on earth would be really good with that kind of sword? Because I kind of like that kind of sword looks like it would look really good with the pirate Kaya skin. Like if it's an attack based event weapon. I might be putting it on him. It is attack? Okay, then yeah, I might be putting that on Kaya. Because that looks so cool. That looks cool. Or if Silali is a sword unit instead of... I'm assuming she's going to be Catalyst. She feels like a Catalyst, but I don't know. But if she's a sword unit, then she might have that too. I don't know. That looks cool. Okay, anyway, sorry. Moving on.
At the bottom of a mysterious accident that occurred within their...
Oh, Layla! Tribe. Hang on,
Travelers
got a good point.
Travelers will need to complete combat challenges to defeat enemies who try to disrupt the ritual. They'll also need to reconstruct scenes from the tribe's woven scrolls.
Ooh.
And gather lost spirits scattered throughout the region. Travelers
Ooh.
Will only be able to uncover the truth if they collect all the clues.
Puzzle,
but don't worry,
hide and
there
seek?
There are also various rewards to earn along the way. Including primo gems
and crowns.
Ooh, I really like the vibe of this event. It looks
look at
like
that.
Silali is performing some kind
look
of ritual.
Look at that.
It's
That's so
mysterious.
Pretty.
When a situation gets tough, it's Granny to the rescue.
Oh my gosh.
Definitely.
Silali and Auroran have some really fun dialogue in this
Aww.
Event.
I'm always grabbing
I'm excited
the
to see that.
Whenever these two interact. They're practically
I
a two-person
show. I love both
show.
Of them.
And speaking of fun, let's get into the event gameplay. First up is the Search for Lost Spirits minigame.
Okay.
Travelers will have to work together to herd the
oh,
scattered
Oh, it's the herding minigame again.
Specific zones.
They just reskinned
points.
It.
Pay attention to the conditions on the field if you want a higher score.
Yeah,
for
they
example,
just reskinned it. It's the herding minigame.
On stone slabs that appear on the field. These slabs will break open and release even more spirits.
Okay, they added
Storms
one
may
new
also
thing.
Appear during the game. You can
okay.
track down spirits more effectively if you pay attention to the direction of the storms.
In Evil Banisher, travelers
Ooh,
will need
fighting.
To select the right teams to complete
yes.
the objectives.
Sign
Completing
me up.
All of the objectives
Sign me
will
up.
Award you the Banishing Aura, which allows you to deal AoE damage by spraying paint at enemies.
That paint really matches the Masters of the Nightwind's aesthetic. It's super cool.
Yeah, and so does the Spirit Loom in restoring Ooh. Fragmented records. Silali will use her powers to reveal special fragments.
Oh, this is
travelers
new!
Travelers will need to piece these fragments together and assemble them on a woven scroll.
Hmm.
Oh, okay,
sure
I actually like this. This is completely new. We've never done anything like this before.
Oh,
I like
that.
That
we should mention. Travelers can obtain a new 4-star sword by completing this event.
Love that sword.
The design definitely fits the Masters of the Nightwind. It looks
oh,
like some
I want
kind
that
of
sword.
Ceremonial artifact.
I totally agree. Oh, and this event will allow travelers to learn more about Natlan's secrets. For example, this quest will reveal new clues about a mysterious and legendary place, the Mare Jivari.
Wait.
Wow, we've been hearing about this place since
Yeah, that's
Mondstadt.
The Windless Place.
It'll be nice to get some new information.
Ooh.
On a related
I'm
note,
excited for that. Okay,
Guild
hold on, pause.
Prepared.
We'll talk about that. There's a lot going on. We need more breaks. Oh my gosh, we need more breaks. The more characters they add to the game, the harder it's going to be for you to get the ones you want, especially with the 4-stars. I would have to agree. So that's why when there's a 4-star I really like, kind of like with Sethos, I try to C6 them right away because the odds of me getting them again is very low. So that's why. Just put the weapons side by side in Genshin chat from their post. Thank you, Sly. I need to see those two bows side by side, the 4-star and the 5-star bow. They look so similar. They look the same. So I think the most fun minigame they had was the tower defense one. That one was really fun and unique. I really do like that one. That one was really fun. I want them to bring that back. Sam, hi. How you doing? I'm doing good. Everyone ready to see Aloy mains go up from 4 to 5 when they release Jessica's weapon? It's funny you say that. So I looked at leaks. I normally don't look at leaks. But I looked at leaks for Auron so I can pre-farm for him, and I have 2 builds already ready to go for him. But I was kind of done, like, farming. So I was like, so who can I level up while I'm waiting for Auron to come out? I'm like, you know what? I still have Aloy. I still have Aloy. So I now have a 3/4 fully built Aloy with crit rate, crit damage, and cryo goblet and everything. I just need to work on her bow and her talents and she'll be ready to go. So yeah, if that oh actually holy shoot, hold on. That bow would actually look amazing on her. Oh no, that bow would actually look fantastic on her. Oh. Okay, focus on Auron first. Depending on him, we decide on if we get C6. Depending on who the next patch is going to be after drip marketing this week, we'll decide if we keep going. If it's nobody, okay, here's the thing. If it's nobody good in the drip marketing, then we pull for the bow for Aloy. Then we pull for the bow for Aloy. Oh my gosh, I can't believe I'm saying that. I can't. Oh, that's going to be great. That's great. Oh, this is going to be fantastic. Lesser Bennett was found. Yeah. The Javari, I can never pronounce it, but the Windless Place. Yeah. That's where Bennett was found. And I remember a lot of people saying that people from Mondstadt are terrified of going there because if they die, their soul like never makes it back to Mondstadt. So like, a lot of adventurers are terrified of that place. It's going to be really cool to get more lore on that. Last break is at the very end. I got you. Mare Javari, there it is. Thank you. Yeah, Venti had to go and freaking rescue a guy's soul from there. The bow is Chaska's main and her best 4-star option. Ah, there you go. Basically missing the pinions in the recurve section. That's such tiny little details. If it is, oh gosh. Drip marketing will be Muika and Silali. If it's both of them, okay, here's the thing. I really want Silali. Like, more than the Pyro Archon, I think. I'm only getting the Pyro Archon because I have all the other Archons. I'm doing that weird collector thing. Oh. But I really want Silali because I don't care what she's going to be. I'm putting her on a team with Auron. Let's be real. I don't know. We'll find out for sure in like a week when they release the drip marketing. But if Silali is coming out in the next patch in 5.3, we're going to have to get a C1 or just a one copy of Auron. We won't be able to do the 6. Oh, there's so much riding on what's going to happen in the next patch. Oh, yikes. Oh, yikes, yikes, yikes. 0.3 of the patches was always the new Archon. I don't remember what the pattern is for that. Alex. I'll have to take a look again. Silali reminds you of March 7th. She's got the similar color scheme. But she kind of... She weirdly reminds me of a gerbil. Like, the face and the weird round discs in her hair reminds me of a gerbil. I don't know why, but she's so cute. Alex says, still in complete denial, Columbina will come out. So that's one of the reasons why I'm so picky. Even though I have easily 200 wishes, why I'm being so picky is because I really badly want whatever Harbinger is coming next. And I am saving because I want to get every single character in Shesnaya. I want to get all of them. Oh, and that's going to be like the next update after 5.x. Oh, boy. It's going to be like 5 minutes to the end. I got you. Oh, are they the same English VA? Silali and March. Oh, I learned something new today. Silali and Farazan would adore each other, but also try and one-up each other. Oh, they absolutely would. They 110% absolutely would. Yes, they would. I wonder if they would work well on a team together. No, they wouldn't, because she boosts Animo and nothing else. Other than 1.1, they usually do whatever the version is, 0.2 patches, the Archons, unless they lose their Archon hood, in which case Fiorina was that one outlier. Gotcha. Thank you, Sly. All right, let's keep going. What's the next event?
Prepared a new trial for its members. Active Ooh, Adventurers Guild? Have been invited to take on the challenge, including the Traveler. Travelers will need to complete various challenges with designated characters
Ooh,
and fully leverage their skills
to
earn rewards.
These are nice because you get to like learn more about how the characters work. I like that.
The Knights of Favonius are conducting a war game
Wait,
to improve
war game? Wait, war game? Wait.
And who better to test these tactics than the honorary knight? Be sure to pay close attention to the game since the format has changed this time. Travelers will need to select combat units and stratagems to deploy against the opposing formation. Once the lineup is set, the monsters will fight automatically.
Oh, it's this Available one.
Combat units and strategies
I'm weirdly bad
random.
At this one.
You know, just to build some unpredictability into the war game. The chances of encountering elite combat units increases as the war game progresses.
I might have to look up some
Even
guides on this.
Elite monsters will be available for travelers to use. It's a volatile environment, so do your best to win as many rounds as possible, earn war game medals, and collect the rewards.
At least it's All more right.
Let's
stable.
Let's keep the excitement rolling in this next event. We actually have a demo,
like, hang
so
on.
Please take a look.
At least it's more stable, like you're not running down hallways in order to place your units. At least it's more like an actual, like, arena battle. I do like that. I didn't like running down up and down the hallways last war game. So that's better. That's better. I do like that.
Oh, looks like they're selecting tactics. Double damage? That sounds powerful.
Oh, they amping up the TCG.
Oh, it's automated.
What?
Cool. The elemental reaction effects are completely different.
I'm sorry, what? They gave us
this
auto battles in
battle
the TCG?
Automatic artistry. Powerful support cards have been added for nearly
I don't
every
know how I feel
elemental
about this.
Reaction. Choose cards that align with your strategies to trigger powerful elemental reactions.
I don't know how I feel about this.
How you
Wait,
play.
Also four cards?
Addition,
Wait, there's four
the
cards now? So three?
Is very laid back.
Characters is it laid back? It does not look laid back to me.
Skill animations are now shorter in length.
Wow, it's like we got a whole new Genius Invocation TCG after coming back from Natland.
I have to, like,
Talk
amp up my
less.
Team. My team is slacking
right.
on the TCG.
Even if you've never played Genius Invocation before, I really recommend
I still need to beat Risley and get his card.
In version 5.2. The new version will also bring a few Ooh. Updates to regular Genius Invocation TCG.
Those are good.
You feel a little cooped up while you're playing card games? Well, don't worry about
That's
that.
That's some really
Our
good
next
art.
Our event will give travelers the opportunity to enjoy the great outdoors. In Claw Convoy, travelers will need
What's
to
this?
Help Lamia track down some adopted animals. Travelers will be able to see the animal's point of view by using a special tool.
Oh, it's this again!
Once you've managed to deduce their location,
oh, this was
you'll
fun.
Be able to track them down. Once
I
the
like
animals
this.
Are safe and sound, travelers will receive a gift from the mysterious
It's really laid back and chill.
Them. I feel like Auroron would really shine in this
I'm
event.
Sorry, is that a hootowl plush?
Definitely an animal lover.
Oh, she's got a little
that.
Backpack.
I'm sure that he would jump at the chance to meet animals
oh,
from other
that's
nations.
Cute. Yeah.
Finally, the ley line overflow
ley
that
lines.
Will return in version 5.2.
I'm going to
need
more Mora after this. All my
Mora
is going to disappear after
out.
Level up Auroron.
All right, let's dive into some updates and game optimizations.
Game optimizations!
First
game
up is
optimizations.
A change to the Imaginarium Theater.
Oh?
Previously, travelers would be returned to the theater lobby after completing a challenge and have to reopen
hey,
the Fantasia
back.
Tome to continue. Travelers provided feedback that this setup interrupted their experience.
That's true.
So, this will no longer be the case in version
5.2. Oh, thank you. We can just do it in
now,
one
after
run.
After finishing a battle, all you need to do is click next act if you want to keep fighting.
Nice.
That's nice.
Travelers
I like
now
that.
Enjoy the thrill of combat without any interruptions.
And for all the generous travelers who like to configure supports for their friends, a supporting caster record has been added in the new update. You can now check which friends have borrowed your supports by looking at the supporting
caster. I was always wondering about
screen.
That. I'm glad they
cool.
add that.
It'll be nice to know that our supports are helping people out.
Someone is yep. curious on like
oh,
who uses what characters.
The configuration mechanic has also been optimized. Besides the elemental
oh.
filtering, the Imaginarium Theater
oh,
will now
yeah,
feature
filtering.
Recommended
Thank
role
you.
Icons, elemental statistics, and markers for the main types of animals.
Oh my
that
gosh,
so
thank
helpful.
You.
I'll
you can
put
see what has an advantage ahead of time.
Just
thank you.
With some characters, but this information should make it a lot easier to form strategic teams.
These markers will display key information on how to counter enemies, but in a much more prominent position.
That's going
to
be so nice.
This change will make it easier for travelers to form the best teams.
Yes. Now we can directly see which elements work best against specific enemies.
Oh,
That's
I'm going to have less of a headache with theater.
Time.
Let's go.
Sure. And we can expect even more optimizations in the future as travelers continue to provide valuable feedback about their experience.
I'm glad they're listening.
Okay, let's introduce the other system optimizations coming in version 5.2. You can now sort 5-star artifacts in your inventory based on when you obtained them.
Oh,
from the most recent
thank
to
you.
The oldest. Second, the animations for crafting materials, forging weapons, building furniture,
Ooh,
and cooking
faster.
Dishes are now shorter in length.
Oh, thank
That's
you.
Really nice. The dev team designed lot of intricate animations for these features, but it can feel a bit frustrating when you have to watch them over and over again.
Especially with smaller items.
There will also be several optimizations for the Serena teapot.
I'm sorry, teapot?
The
teapot?
The dispensary can now hold more of every type
yeah!
of seed. You'll be able to purchase wood at the Realm Depot in exchange for realm currency.
More plants!
In addition, the cooldown for the boon of the Elder Tree
yes!
will be reduced to 5 seconds.
It's 5 seconds instead
this
of like 20!
It'll be easier
oh,
for travelers
as a teapot man,
wood.
I'm so happy.
Awesome. I've been meaning
I'm
to
so
use
happy.
Some cool replicas in my Serena teapot, but
oh,
I'm
that makes
always
me delighted.
Short on wood. So this should be really helpful.
Nice! I'm so excited for you. Oh, and optimizations
that's
have been
good.
Made to artifact locking.
I'm sorry,
the
what?
The updated lock assistance interface will allow you to configure lock settings with a single click. Just hit use recommended settings and you're set. The recommended set lock plans will even update automatically based on popular in-game configurations. Of course, if you have your own ideas in mind, then you can always disable the recommended plans to configure custom ones instead.
The update
just give
also
us artifact
allows you
loadouts.
To batch lock artifacts in your inventory based on the recommended general lock plan and set lock plans.
Just
this will make it much
chance.
Faster to organize your inventory. In addition,
so
a shortcut button that navigates to the lock assistance interface will be added
okay,
to the artifact
that's a little
domain
nice.
Challenge screen and the artifact acquisition screen. This should make
okay,
it easier
convenient.
For travelers to configure their locking rules whenever they want. A star feature will also be added next to the lock button on
yes!
each artifact.
Okay, that's probably the closest thing we got to loadouts.
This feature
is
to
the
mark
favorite
their
icon.
Favorite artifacts and
yes!
stars to quickly track
okay,
them down.
Okay, that is probably
finally,
as close as we're going to get.
This will now be
I'll
able
take
to locate
it.
Even more treasure locations,
huh?
including Seelies and time trial challenges.
Yes, it's
a
no longer just boxes.
A quick stop feature will also be added for treasure compasses and Oculus resonance stones. Enabling this feature will allow
Wait.
Travelers to more easily use these devices across regions. The feature will automatically switch
oh,
to the compass
thank
or stone
you.
That corresponds
so
to your
long.
Location in the game.
I'm awesome. Glad they just automatically
swap now. Be sure to check
out
future announcements for more details on the
thank
version 5.2 optimizations.
All right.
Yeah, so we don't have to
that
go to the menu and swap it each time. That's nice.
This seems like a good time for our second break.
It's time for the third redemption code.
Third and final redemption code. I love those optimizations. Those are nice. Watch an anime on Netflix? Hey, it's a good day for anime. Oh, Ugly Monkey. You gotta watch for about 30 minutes, and then if you do the exclamation mark Discord, it will Twitch will whisper the link to you.
You guys want me to say ada-ada?
Gosh darn it, Panda! Hi, by the way. 98!
Go to the pop, don't stop.
Aww, that's above an 80%. Congratulations, you get a... Da-da-da. Gosh darn it. What else did I miss? Buy wood. Yeah! So if you ever run out of wood and you can't, like, find any more, or you're like me and you chop down every single tree in your world and have to wait till tomorrow. Yeah. That's nice. That's gonna be nice. Best running joke in Genshin is the Archons have no more, huh? Yeah, we have no rich Archon. It's really interesting.
Welcome back, travelers.
You guys want me to
okay.
say
ada-ada? Hold on. Hold on. Hold on. What was that? Three? One, two, three. There you go. Have fun. And then let me figure out that percentage there. You know, the moment Shaznaya is out, we're going to have a freaking heyday. Wait till December. Wait till December. I need my pumpkin pie first. Okay, hold on. Let me see. 42%! Haha! That is. Whoops. I hit the wrong button. Alright, we get it again. Have fun. As a 42%, as under 80%, so the closest thing I can give you is an orca. Orca. I'm telling you to suck anime! What's the commands for them? You're testing my memory. So exclamation mark commands is for everyone. Everyone can use those. I believe it's exclamation mark VIP. I think it's that. Hang on, I can triple check. That's it. So subscribers, if you're a subscriber or a VIP, which you get VIP by buying something on Throne, you can use any of those and they all have the little time limits with them. Except I just realized I need to get rid of exclamation mark feed. Oh, that makes me sad. I need to write that down. Give me 10 won't work because I'm recovering from acute confusional migraines and I don't want to exercise that intensely while waiting for my head to heal. Okay, hang on. I need to write that down. Exclamation mark feed I need to get rid of. Oh, that's sad. I mean, you guys want me to take a picture of Salt, Pepper, and Ryuji? And just keep exclamation mark feed? Because Brian isn't
Let's
there?
Have a drink!
Think of the hydrate. Still got water. Got a little bit of water left. Sure. Akihiko was saying, no, do them! I will make myself worse if I do them. Like I gotta be really careful. Okay, hang on. Let's finish up these last 5 minutes and then we'll talk over everything.
What else do we have on the agenda, Gabe?
We have some very exciting news to share.
News?
After the version update,
I've been waiting for this.
Travelers will be able to play Genshin Impact on the Xbox Series X and S.
Where's
Log
the
into Genshin Impact on Xbox Series X and S consoles to receive the Wind Glider Wings of Fate's Course Intertwined.
Wait, what?
Additionally, Xbox Game Pass Ultimate members can play Genshin Impact via cloud.
Wait. I need to hang on. Wait. What does that look like? Wait. Because that name sounds really familiar. Wings of Fate. Isn't that the PlayStation 1? Fate, C-O-U-R, course, I-N-T-E-R, T-W-I-N-E. Isn't that the PlayStation? Oh, it's a new one? It is a new one. It's green. I'm surprised I actually didn't. Wait, did they show an image? Hang on.
Additionally,
I might be jumping
Xbox
the gun.
Game Pass Ultimate members can play Genshin Impact via cloud gaming. They'll also find extra rewards in their in-game mailbox.
Awesome.
All right. That
nope, they're not
going to
show
everything.
It. Yeah, so the wings themselves look green. And then close to like the shoulder blades is a little bit of white. That looks really cool. Is it going to be like the PlayStation wings where like you can only use them if you're playing on that console? I got a feeling that's what it's going to be like. Get a friend to log in to the Xbox with your account. That's fair. Anybody got an Xbox? Xbox version X or S? Oh, shoot. I know. I have a 362. I have a 360 and an OG. Like the original Xbox. That's it. Xbox is permanent. All platforms is next patch only. Wait, what? Huh? So Venti or I'll hate them. Actually, it would look really good on I'll hate them. Not gonna lie. Oh, we get the glider in 5.3. Okay. Okay, it's next patch. Okay. Gotcha. Only in 5.3. But we don't know how yet. Okay. So right now, in 5.2, for those who have Xbox, you'll be able to get the glider. But in 5.3, everyone will be able to get the glider? That's nice. I like that. I wish they did that with the PlayStation ones, because I have the PlayStation wings. And I love them. They are so pretty. But again, you can only use them on PlayStation. Like, if you go over to your PC, you can't use the wings. And it makes me sad. And I wish they fixed that. It's pretty. Yeah, and they get like little bonus rewards. Probably like Mora and XP level up and things like that. It's not bad. Okay, let's finish up this real quick.
That means that we've reached the end of the special program.
Honestly, these two did a fantastic job.
Anything you want to say before we go, Kai?
Yes, I'm really looking forward to all the new characters. Chaska and her weapons seem really incredible. I'd love to see how her travel chronicle unfolds because she has such an amazing personality. And Auroran seems like a very layered character. The storytelling is definitely going to shine.
I'm
what
so
about you,
excited
Gabe?
For that story.
Yeah, I'm just so excited for players to experience more of the Natland storyline. And we have so much to explore this time. I mean, two new tribes and a new area as well. And One thing I've always loved about Genshin Impact is how it's multi-platform. Like, I'm always logging in on different devices depending on where I am. So
me using
it's
my
just
PC
exciting
and phone.
To see another platform become available for everyone.
Yeah.
And yeah, on that note, I hope you have fun with the new version, travelers.
Bye.
Bye.
They're doing really good as villains. They're doing really, really good as villains for the voice actors and stuff. Kai and Gabe, they did a really good job this time. They're doing great. 10 out of 10. Should Mew World use the PlayStation Wings? No, I have to be on PlayStation to use the PlayStation Wings. That's what sucks. There we go. Sorry, that was a little loud. There you go. Oh yeah, he's in the ZZZ ones too. That's true. Once we get Yuri on the special programs, everyone will freak out. Yeah, when we get Daneslip on a special program, it's game over. It's end game time. You know we got a problem when Dane shows up.
Oh boy.
You want them to do all the streams? Honestly, I kind of do too. Because then, like, it feels, I don't know. It's nice to, like, see the voice actors, like, kind of say a line or two in their character. But, like, at the same time, it doesn't feel like an announcement. It feels a little not candid. But, like, these guys, it feels natural. It feels right, if that makes any sense. But I like that. I found out that Japanese Dane voices one character you love from a show in a book. Ah, there you go. Yeah. Terrifying but sweet character. Fanica, hello! We're doing good! We just finished up with a special program and just kind of chit-chatting over it. But, like, good gravy. I'm gonna stall around the Genshin crossover. Oh, me too. Me too. They're doing Impact 3rd. And Star Rail. So I'm waiting. Gosh. Okay, so the events, I want to just mute that. The events I'm really looking forward to this time. Like, the fighting one, I always like fighting events. Those are fun. This hurting one, I'm on the fence about. Because we've kind of had it before, and it doesn't really look like there's going to be too much of a difference. But this one here, whoop, nope. This one here, where we have to move like the puzzles together, like the puzzle pieces together to actually make an image. I like this. This I'm excited for, just a really simple gameplay. That's gonna be really nice. And then learning about the Mare Jhavari and that one. This one here, we get to try out different characters. That's going to be a really good test of skill there. This one, again, like I said, I'm probably going to struggle with these because I don't know why, but I can't comprehend these ones, the battle-like ones, very well. So I might have to look up a couple of guides, but I am glad that it is a classic battle, like simulator kind of look, instead of like you have to run around and place things. So that's nice. And then TCG's got that update. Also the little animal mini game, I'm glad they're bringing that back. That one, I am so glad they're bringing that back. I loved that one. It was a nice little challenge to try to figure out where everybody is. This one here. Where is that card? There it is. Claw Convoy. This one near the end of the update. That's going to be really, really nice. The optimizations, I am actually really glad about those. I am glad that they're changing up things in Imaginum Theater to make planning a lot easier. And also the fact that we can now pretty much mark our favorites for artifacts is going to be nice, because that's going to be the closest we can get to loadout slots in Genshin Impact. So now instead of like, if you're trying to like build a character that you don't have yet and you have to like shove those artifacts in like your lowest level character, you don't need to do that no more. You just mark them as your favorite and they can just stick in your bag, which is nice because now I can actually go in and build those low level characters like I've been planning to do without having fear of like losing my markers. So that's nice. I like that. And then of course, I'm really excited about the fact that we can buy wood and the wood gathering thing is like takes less time. Cause I'm constantly building stuff in my teapot. Like I have 3/4 of my teapot done. I opened up a new area and started just building like a mad lad. I need to do like the inside of the house and like one island. And then it's all done. But I'm also really glad we're getting more seeds because mine has been maxed out for weeks. Been maxed out for weeks. So that's gonna be really, really nice. Again, I'm nervous about the banners, where they go. Especially this one. I'm gonna be skipping the Nouvellet and Zhongli one, even though more constellations for Zhongli would be nice, I think I'm still gonna skip those. And again, it all depends on what drip marketing will be for 5.3.
I will have order.
Yeah. Like, I kind of wish Auron was actually paired with Zhongli, because that would make my life so much easier. Which 4 stars will be on the banner? We don't know yet, Joe. The only one that we know is for confirmed is going to be Auron in the phase 1. Phase 2, we won't know yet until it gets closer. I kind of hope whoever the other 3 4 stars will be that are paired with Auron or ones I already have maxed at C6. Because then that's an extra wish for me, and that's going to be really nice. Yeah, they did. A long time ago, they used to tell us, like, the whole banner beforehand. So, yeah. We're going to keep an eye out for that. It'll be interesting. Calling the artifact Lilith will be the very last update of the game. Gosh darn it. But I am also really excited for the story, too. And seeing more of those bat critters. There it is! Look at him! He's so adorable! He's just so tiny! Those big ol' ears! Oh, I'm gonna be spending way too much time. I'm gonna be spending way too much time in this town. Like, way too much time. Like, I thought People of the Springs was my place. No, 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 no. Nah, I'll be over here. They just hover when they use their skill and stuff, and they're like so bouncy. Oh, I love them. I kind of wish we can have Saurians on our teapot. You know? I wish we could have like little Saurians on our teapot, because that would be really cool. Just like a neat little detail.
He's so fluffy.
Literally me looking at these little bat critters. Oh, they're so cute. Seriously, when these things become marketable and they make plushes of them, I'm getting one. Gonna be nuts. Okay, I think we talked about everything. I think we're all good for like an hour and a half. I tripled the time. I don't know how. This thing is only 30 minutes long and I manage to triple the time every time. The Fontaine Otter plush. Oh, that one is cute. Yeah, they already made the other 3. I'm just waiting until they make this thing marketable. I'm waiting. Alrighty. Let's go ahead and wrap things up here and head over here for the night. There we go. Okay, hang on. I gotta stop sitting.
Far is a Saurian vet. He might have a passive that has something to do with Saurians in the teapot.
That is true. He is a vet. So we might. If he does, he's gonna absolutely be my favorite. Because already he's kind of my favorite. Just because he's friends with... with Auron. But we'll see. We'll see. Speaking of Fontaine, got to Fontaine a couple of days ago. Hey, there you go. Honestly, Fontaine is probably one of my favorite regions. I love the look of it, especially the area around the... why am I spacing on the name? It's Opera something. Opera something. What is it called? Help. It's where the Oratrice Mechanique Denalise Cordonnelle is housed. Alp, what is that area called? I'm spacing out. That's gonna drive me nuts. Epicles! That's the one. Opera Epicles. That's the place. No, Meripede's cool, but no, Opera Epicles. The area around there looks a lot like my home. And I love it. The mountains, the plants, the pines. It's great. Artifact loadout plush. Yeah, for now, Fontaine is my favorite. But wait till we get to Shesnaya. Wait till we get to the snow. Alrighty. Let's go on another adventure, ladies and gentlemen. Let's go on an adventure and see who's doing things. Go raid someone. Go hang out with them for a bit. Also, by the way, thank you guys so much for just hanging out with me and dealing with me, like, fangirling over bats. So thank you so much. This has been fun. This is fun. I'm excited. Gonna be a couple of weeks. Sooner's on? Sooner is! They are playing Dragon Age, the Veilguard. Go hang out with them. Did they just start? Hang on. Oh, I'm stuck in an ad.
Please hold, ad loading.
Because if they just start, we can beep up over there. Yeah, let me prep. Yeah, like an hour ago. Adventure to Lyra's Adventure. I can't raid myself. Twitch won't let me. Yeah, because I definitely need to stand up and go grab some more medicine. Because I've been slacking. Then I need to do my dailies in Genshin. I need to do a lot of things. Do I have the brain power to do it? No. Okay, yeah, he's only been alive for like an hour 15, so that's perfect. Cool beans. So we're gonna head on over there and hang out with Suna. For those of you who don't know, he's a good friend of mine. He's a PNG VTuber. He actually drew my PNG model on days where I need it. And if you guys want a raid message to use, the first one there is absolutely free for anyone to use. The second one here is if you're a subscriber, you can use those emotes that I drew myself. Or if you want to make up your own little message, absolutely feel free to do so. We're going to head on over. Once again, thank you guys so much for joining me on this little adventure of ours. We are not going to have a stream tomorrow. However, we are going to have our very first watch party in Discord. We're going to be watching Lucario and the Mystery of Mew from Pokemon. That's going to be about the same time as when we started stream today, 1 p.m. Mountain Standard Time. So look forward to that. Hopefully nothing breaks as this is our first watch party ever. So we'll see how it goes. Otherwise, Sunday we'll be back with some more Oratrice Mechanique Denalise Cordonnelle.
We now turn to the Oratrice Mechanique Denalise Cordonnelle.
No, otherwise we'll be back Sunday for some more drawing. I think we're going to be working on Albedo next.
What the Flello doing? Flello's at work. Flello's at work.
But alrighty, you guys go have fun. I'll see you later. Bye!
I turn around and everything has changed. Looking for a way to work it out. I'm trying to find some peace to navigate.